Sons of Saw 3! Hello, and welcome back to another Gunpla review. Today we're taking a look at the Zakutu Revive Mass Production Type. Alright, and starting off, as always, with the articulation. The eye is on a track and can move left and right. That's helped by having a convenient little tab on the bottom here. Then the head is on a ball joint, can get a full rotation, and look that far back, and stupidly far forward. Then the side of the chest is on a ball joint. Shoulders themselves are on a forward-facing hinge, as well as a peg. The shoulder armor is on a ball joint, though you don't get a lot of movement out of it. This shoulder armor is on a swivel, and then a hinge. And of course, the arm can go out to the side, though not quite to 90 degrees. Rotation at the bicep, hinge at the elbow, swivel at the elbow, second hinge at the elbow, ball joint in the midsection of the forearm, and the hands are on technically ball joints, though they're so deep set in there you're not getting much more than a wiggle. Waist can rock side to side, slightly, forward and back, decently, and can actually fully rotate. Front skirts are ball jointed, though the ball joint is set a little bit low because of the soft skirt gimmick. Side skirts are hinged, back skirt solid. The hips are just universal joints, though they have no trouble getting whatever pose you want out of them. Then there's a full rotation at the thigh, a double jointed knee for a full bend, though the hose does get put under stress from this, so you might want to be a bit careful with that. And a ankle that's so complicated I'm not going to explain the mechanism of it. Basically, it can go back that far, forward that far, and has a pretty nice tilt to either side. Just like the Char version, this kit has amazing articulation, though it seems that the tolerances are already starting to get a little lax. The ball joints in the wrists, especially. Not hard to tighten, just something to keep in mind. Now, getting into accessories, let's start off, as always, with the sticker sheet and, by extension, color correction. If you can't tell, that's the mono eye. I kind of feel like they could have included a couple extra ones for the weapon cameras, but honestly, that's not a huge deal. However, aside from that, things fully color separated. The only thing I've done is panel lining, and honestly, panel lining is pretty much all you need to do. This kit looks really, really good. Again, like I was saying about the mold having a little degradation. These seams are worse on this than on the Char version, and the really, it almost looks like they misaligned the molds. Because I can't imagine it's this bad after, you know, a year of runs. But getting into the accessories proper, you get two holding hands. Technically, you get a third holding hand, but it's completely identical, so there's no reason to cut it out. You do, however, get two trigger finger hands, and you can see the difference in plastic between them because the left one comes on the weapon runner. It's not a huge deal, and it's not super noticeable, but it is something to keep in mind. And finally, you get an open splayed hand, which is pretty standard for Zeon units at this point. I'm pretty sure they've used the same sculpt for almost every suit in the past 10 years. Then moving on to the weapons, you get a Heat Hawk, just the one, so if you're going to paint it, you have to decide whether you want it to be activated or not, or just get multiples like me. I do kind of wish they would include two, but hey, this is reused from the High Mobility Zaku, so it's not like they could just add a second one. Oh wait. Because they did actually include this little adapter piece to attach it onto the side skirt in that little hole right there. Just plugs in the ball joint. And you get the Zaku machine gun, movable secondary handle, movable camera, removable drum with a extra. And this can just be plugged onto the back skirt here. Finally, you get the High Mobility Zaku Bazooka, which, it's not technically accurate, but it's close enough. Get a movable secondary handle, movable main handle, and movable camera. And this can actually be stored on the back skirt. If you flip down this, it just sits right there. And doesn't really hold on at all, to be honest. Technically it's storage, but it's not the most secure thing in the world. And you get a little adapter for any sort of stand you want to put it on. This just plugs up under the skirt, has a 3mm hole, and has a pretty secure connection. Also, you do get the Commander Finn version of the head. And you can see from these turnstiles that the regular head goes here, and this was missing on the Shark kit. Now, finally, let's talk about the soft skirt. And you can see I didn't even bother cutting this out on this one because for some reason they didn't think to undergate the front skirt, and so you just end up with really, really ugly nubs on it. And because this is rubber, you can't remove them. Thankfully, they included the hard skirt, which honestly I think looks better anyway because it doesn't have two different textures. Unfortunately, because of the soft skirt, they ended up putting the ball joints on this a little bit lower than they should have, and that kind of makes it not quite as good as it could have been. Basically, what I'm saying is, neat idea, but it was a mistake. And as for a quick size comparison, the Zaku 2 is kind of a small suit. It's shorter than the RX-78 by about half a head. So, to wrap this review up, I have pretty much the same thoughts on this that I did on the Shar Revive. It's an absolutely excellent kit that really you need to own. The engineering is really something else, and even with the concerningly fast mold degradation, it's still an absolutely amazing kit. I never army build, and I bought two of these to go with my Shar Revive. So hopefully that gives you an idea of the quality of this kit. Anyway, that's all for this review. Be sure to let me know what you think down in the comments below. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, helps a lot. Subscribe and hit the bell for future reviews. Go follow me on Twitter for updates. And consider supporting me on Patreon so I can keep making reviews just like this one. And as always, until next time, happy building.